Maps are the mitochondria of first-person shooters, the powerhouse of the cell, if you will. When all you're doing is running around and shooting baddies, you're gonna want to enjoy where it is that you're running around and shooting baddies at. So, how did Call of Duty perform in this category? Well, despite technically only giving us 3 more maps compared to the beta, I'd say fairly mediocre. There aren't necessarily any maps I'd consider hot garbage, but there also aren't any that are gonna go down in the history books as classics. So I figure before Season 1 rolls around to dump some more questionable maps down our gullets, let me go ahead and rank all of the base game maps as a sort of baseline for all these DLC maps fixing to come. Now, mind you, this is all my opinion, so if I rank your favorite map super low, please don't roast me too hard in the comments. Also, for what it's worth, these opinions are coming from someone who primarily plays hardcore, Nuketown 84 will not be included in the listing, and the way these maps play in Onslaught is not taken into consideration in the ranking, because if I'm being real with y'all, I haven't even played that shit yet. Coming in at dead last, the worst map in Cold War is without a doubt Checkmate. I would say I understood what approach they were going for with this one, but that would be a lie. The structure of this map is poo-poo ass, quite bluntly. Like, one spawn is nothing but head glitch spots, the other spawn has annoying towers for snipers, and then there's just an abrasive, kind of wall-bangable but not really plane in the middle of the map. There's also an annoying underbelly of the plane full of walls that should be wall-bangable but aren't, and even more head glitch spots. People don't move, they hold angles with 4x scopes on their ARs. I was literally in a lobby where all 12 people voted for the map that wasn't Checkmate. It doesn't help that lethal aerial score streaks are borderline useless since 90% of the map is roofed off. Checkmate is just the hottest garbage in a game full of mediocrity, and it rightfully deserves last place. Coming in at 7th place is Miami. Putting this map this low really hurts me, because I love the look of Miami. The super colorful and sharp LEDs in comparison to the dark night sky are phenomenal. I remember loading into a match of Miami in the beta, and Ulf Hednarhide and I both said at the same time, "Oh shit, this is Vice City." The look is on point with this map, and it is easily the best looking map in the game, but that's literally all it has going for it. The way this map plays is terrible. It's too open in some places, other places are super open but obstructed with a bunch of clutter, B-flag is atrocious, people camp that hotel balcony like it's going out of season. The map is just too clunky to be enjoyable, and as a matter of fact, the only reason Miami is above Checkmate is because of its aesthetic. I prefer the gameplay on Checkmate over Miami, and that's just a testament to how mega poopoo this map really is. Our 6th place spot is gonna go to Cartel. Now, I don't know if I'm just missing something here or what, cause people seem to be in love with this map. Mind you, I don't dislike it, I just don't seem to like it as much as other people seem to like it. I find that grass patch in the middle of the map abrasive and obnoxious, that tower overlooking B-flag is way too easy to be hidden in, and there are a lot of head glitch spots around the map that also cause some annoyance. I do really like the look and the feel of the map though. It screams Black Ops 1 to me, and the simple map design is surprisingly refreshing. Overall, it's a pretty solid map. In 5th place, we have Armada Strike. Armada is by no means a bad map necessarily, it's just so boringly average. The only thing I like this map for is how easy it is to get cover kills on it. Other than that, it is just the definition of meh. The color scheme is whatever, the location is whatever, it's just a nothing map. No one's gonna remember this map in 13 months, and no one's gonna hold 1v1s on this map. It's just boring and forgettable. Coming in at 4th place is Savlon. Similarly to Armada Strike, this is where the maps really to begin the mediocre range. Unlike Armada though, some actual fun can be had on this map. The broken satellite area on B-flag is really fun, the dunes are good for long shots, both spawns are pretty balanced. Overall, the map is really solid. The only annoying part, like I mentioned earlier, are the dunes. Tons of people just prone with 4x LMGs and absolutely stomp the lobby since their outfit ever so conveniently matches the overwhelming color of the sand. Other than the dunes being an occasional nuisance, this map is very, very solid. In 3rd place, we have Garrison. In my original revision of this video, Garrison was my number one spot. Obviously, that's not the case anymore, and the reason for that is because I realized the reason I like this map so much was because it was a map I was decent at. By no means is Garrison a very, very good map. I had just developed strats and mechanics for playing on it. So after getting stomped in a hardcore dom match the other day, I decided to actually look at this map more objectively, and yeah, it's kinda whatever. Mind you, I like this map. The open area on A spawn is really fun, and the middle area, although pretty cluttered, can be fun for gunfights. The little underneath alleys can prove to be annoying, but it's also easy to get rid of the enemies in there, and the head glitch tanks in the middle are really annoying, and that tank on C spawn that literally lets you spawn camp A side is atrocious, but other than that, this is for sure one of my favorites. In second place, we have Moscow. Moscow was my favorite map from the beta, and it's still very enjoyable. The design is simple and effective, B flag is actually good, and the only annoying area of the map I feel is the street with all the cars. Other than that, this map is really fun to play. However, it's not all that fun to look at. The overwhelmingly gray color scheme with the occasional hue of red can be pretty suffocating, but I feel that the action of this map overrides that aspect. Really fun map, one of my favorites. But it ain't my favorite, baby, because coming in at the number one spot, my favorite map in Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War is Crossroads Strike. Crossroads Strike is such a good map, dude. The building is tight but not suffocating. The open areas are pretty prone to, well, proners with magnified ARs, but even then, there's just enough clutter to allow cover for pushes. The only genuine gripe I have is an issue with two operators getting a sort of unintentional advantage on this map. The snow is so damn bright and white, and with the blue undertones everywhere, songs love to prone in the snow with 4x ARs, and the base skin Sims can literally blend into the rock wall on A spawn. Other than the visual exploits, which really do need to be addressed, like seriously, please Treyarch, help us out, I love this map. It's great for bloodthirsties, it's good for point blanks, Crossroads Strike is my favorite map in Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War, and definitely within my top 10 best from Call of Duty of all time. And that's all the maps. Remember, this was a list on base game maps only, hence the exclusion of Nuketown 84. But for what it's worth, Nuketown would probably be placed above Miami, but below Cartel, just off the top of my head, at least. Regardless, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I'm sorry I've been gone for over a month, I've just had a lot on my plate here lately, but I really am trying to prioritize you guys a bit more. Thank you so much for your patience and understanding, I genuinely really really do appreciate it from the bottom of my heart, but nonetheless, take it easy, y'all. I'll see you in the next one.